And a new plan to keep Kiwis safer on our roads has been revealed as the road toll continues to climb. Transport agency Waka Kotahi's speed management plan will see speeds lowered across more than 500 kilometres of our state highways. In total, it will affect 440 locations, including outside many schools and marae across the country. It comes as the road toll this year soars. 320 people have died so far. That's more than the whole of last year, and if it keeps tracking this way, it'll be a five-year high. For more on this, we're joined by road safety campaigner Clive Matthew Wilson alongside Brake New Zealand director Caroline Perry. Morena you two, it's so nice to have you both with us in the studio. Thank you so much for your time. Caroline, how are we getting this so wrong? Why are we still here having these conversations about record high road tolls in this country?
Oh, look, the number of deaths on our roads this year is heartbreaking. As an organisation, we support people who've been bereaved in crashes, and we see the consequences, and it is awful to still be talking about how high our numbers of deaths and serious injuries are. So we have a lot of things to do in order to bring that down, and safe speed limits is one of them.
Clive, a lot of people will be very shocked to hear those numbers. The fact that we're tracking on track for possibly a five-year road toll high.
Okay, so let's talk facts, not emotions, okay, because we're here to save lives. First of all, the road toll's going down, not up. So in the 1970s, when we had, 3 million people, it was 876 in 1 year. Think about that, right? But from the 1980s onwards, which is when we started installing median barriers on roads and getting cars with airbags, it's been actually per head of population, it's been going very gradually down since then, so this is actually a victory. Now, the highs and the lows, the little highs and lows, simply follow the economy, because when there's more, say, builders' labourers employed, that's more money to buy booze to then crash a car into a wall. So actually, the overall trend is actually down. This is alarmist and simply not true, not a true representation of the situation. You think it was 876 in the 70s. It's now getting down to a third of that, and the highs and lows follow the economy. The overall trend is downwards and has been since the late 80s.
Yes, but still, more than 300 people have died on our roads this year.
That's right. Now, Prime Minister promised to build the median barriers to stop that, and has been completely useless. What the Auckland Harbour Bridge used to have one serious or fatal crash per week. And they had the same silly campaigns, lower the speed, lower the road, the speed limit, we'll be out in force tonight, ask people to drive safely. None of it makes any difference. Where they installed a median barrier, the serious crashes overnight, and basically never came back. What does that tell you?
Caroline, Clive says you've got to look at the facts and take the emotion out of it, but shouldn't emotion almost be at everything that we're at the forefront of everything that we're talking about here? Shouldn't emotion be the reason why we're having these conversations?
It's an important part, and certainly take Clive's point that we have been trending down over a few decades, but from our point of view as the organisation that we are, and dealing with the aftermath of crashes, 320 people is 320 people too many dying on our roads, and the families and communities that have the long-lasting effect of that. Of course, there is emotion in it as well, and we have to look at all of the things that we need to do to bring that number of deaths and serious injuries down to zero. And I take Clive's point that certainly median barriers infrastructure is a really key part of that as well, but safe speed limits are also a key part. The international research into the Vision Zero safe system approach to road safety shows that safe speeds is a key part of that, and bringing those in, particularly as we've talked about around schools and marae, is really important in protecting young people and groups of people who are congregating and particularly walking and cycling.
So this proposal, I'm assuming you're in favour of then, Caroline?
Yeah, so we support safe and appropriate speed limits. This plan has a lot of speed limits around, looking at variable speed limits around schools on state highways and marae at times when people are congregating, and that helps to protect people who might be, obviously when there's lots of traffic around there, and who might be walking, crossing the road, cycling to those venues as well.
Clive, a lot of our feedback though from our viewers doesn't think that this will have much of an impact.
It
what
won't.
Do you think?
85%. 85%, 85% of the road toll occurs below the speed limit, not above the speed limit. And of the speed-related accidents, they're almost exclusively yobbos, drunk drivers, or reckless motorcyclists. So any policy aimed at the average driver is doomed to failure, right? Think about this. The safest road in New Zealand, or one of the safest roads in New Zealand, is also the fastest road in New Zealand. Waikato Expressway, 110K. So if we follow the logic of these arguments, the Waikato Expressway should be the unsafest road in the country. But it's not. Not only that, but the government simply isn't doing its job. It's using this in place of doing its job, because it's an easy solution. You just say, let's lower the road toll in these places. And everybody knows that it's never going to stop while this current pack are making the decisions. This is, they go, if you point out that you know, in various places, it's not going to make any difference because of such and such, they go, oh yeah, but it's going to save emissions. So this is an anti-car initiative, and I never thought I'd say that, because climate change is real. I've been fighting environmental causes for 40 years. But cars have become a symbol of climate change, and attacking cars has become a symbol of solving climate change, even though it won't.
Is this not just another tool in the toolbox, though? Is it not just one way of bringing this road toll down, which we all agree we need to do, right?
Yes, and we could reduce the daytime road toll, according to very credible studies from all over the world. We could reduce the road toll by 20% in the daytime by doing nothing more than making sure all cars had lights on the front. Okay? Completely ignored by the government. And this is one of dozens of initiatives. For example, you watch around Auckland, everybody's on a cell phone. What are the police doing about it? Nothing. They should seize the cell phone used, because, you know, distraction, everyone agrees, is a major cause of accidents. What are the police doing about it? Giving people speeding tickets. And also, people are not wearing seat belts, so it's not, you know, they can be going half the speed limit and not wearing a seat belt. There's virtually no enforcement. They should seize cars where the seat belts are not being used for a week, and very quickly people will stop doing it.
So is this a resourcing issue then, Clive?
It's a seeing the situation clearly issue. If you say, oh, you naughty children are speeding, we're going to have to put all these cameras to stop you speeding and the road toll will go down, and as you just said, it's doing one of those up and down things. Unless you actually deal with the, you know, people are going to behave badly. That's just reality. And 20% of the road toll involves trucks, by the way, and we're not even having that discussion. And also 20%, roughly, of the road toll involves people over the age of 60 who are never speeding. We need to set up the system so that it's safe, but above all else, we need to do strategies that are simple, that work, and have the public on board.
So, Caroline, we've got this road to zero policy at the moment. Can we get there? Can we actually make this a reality?
We can. We support the Road to Zero strategy and the plans that are there, but we have to step up the progress if we are to reach the 2030 targets that are in there, at the 40% reduction. It is really important that we get to that, and certainly infrastructure, enforcement, all of that is really important, tackling things like distractions, seatbelt use, all of those things too. But speed is a factor in all crashes. It may not be the cause of a crash, but it is a factor in the outcome and the likelihood of you being killed or seriously injured. And that is why safe speed limits are so important.
Yeah, although are there other areas we should be focusing more attention on at the moment to reduce that speed limit, that road toll?
It's a combination. So we certainly need better progress in the medium barrier space and that infrastructure space that needs to be happening faster. And we need to look at also the other areas around safe vehicles and road users as well.
Can we get there, Clive?
Well, we can't by this attitude because, you know, as I said, you can stop 100% of head-on collisions with medium barriers. The money is there. It's simply not being collected. Trucks are 20% of the road toll. Two-thirds of the cost of building a highway is in making it solid enough for trucks, and 80% of road maintenance, this is going somewhere, 80% of road maintenance comes from trucks, caused by trucks, but they pay less than a quarter of the cost. As a result, the money isn't being collected to fix our roads, and I'd like to hear the government explain why that isn't so.
So appreciate your time, both of you. Thank you for coming on. We've got to get this right. So that is Clive Matthew Wilson, a road safety campaigner, and Caroline Perry from Brake New Zealand. Thank you so much for coming in and having this discussion with us.
Thanks.